Hello and welcome back to Maester Reviews. Today I'm going to be talking about Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio, a Netflix film released in select theatres internationally. Now, this film is an utter treat for del Toro fans. It has a bit of everything that you could possibly want, as in ideas of dictatorship and this authoritarian society. That's where people are marginalized in society. Then on top of that, you've got ideas of fantasy and reality, and a harsh reality, a blend between the two of them. You've then got all the mystical elements and slight horror undertones, which obviously there's only a fine line to walk there with the Pinocchio story is dealt with. But you add all that together and it becomes, on its own, a far more stylized and arguably better film than Disney's version of this earlier in September that releases a streaming film on Disney Plus. This film deserves everything that it has going for it to top that entry. And all this journey begins in its first 20-25 minutes alone, which are jam-packed with such a heavy-hitting emotion about Geppetto's backstory, which Disney have never nailed home all the way there, because again, it's a children's property. But the heart of that children's property, making once again an adult fairy tale, an adult mythical story, those elements are brought in and anchored down and put full full force is put on them in this edition. And it makes for a much better story with metaphors of time and eternal life and what it means to be alive, which is again slightly brushed over in Pinocchio in the other versions, but in this one it's really drilled home of what does it mean to be a real boy. It means sacrifice and valor and love and care and loyalty. That is what it means to be a real boy, and all of these facets of human behavior are explored and are wonderfully envisioned through metaphors and dialogue and just general story and plot. And the imagery and sequences are done in an incredibly clever way when compared with the original source material. And on top of that, you've then got original songs which Guillermo del Toro made himself. Now, these aren't always particularly memorable, but probably what is the loveliest cinematic song of the entire year is Ciao Papa. And he did write that one, and that is honestly, this by a mile, the standout of the film. Such a heartwarming, heartbreaking tune and melody that completely steals the show in comparison to the rest of the tracks on the album. And that is, it overall, it completes a package that is in probably the top quarter percent of the top 25% of the films this year. An incredible feat of filmmaking, with gorgeous stop motion animation, with grotesque features, but also mild beauty in there as well. And overall, it creates a much stronger finished product than anything Disney has been able to do with that character. So even though Disney's version is very charming, this has more depth, which nowadays I think a film needs. There's obviously escapism, but this year's Pinocchio cannot even hold a candle to this one. So yes, that is my review, my spellbound review of Guillermo del Toro's Pinocchio, and I will see you all next time for my review of Nocebo, if that's how I pronounce it correctly. I'll see you all next time. Goodbye.